Hello everyone. In today's video, I am going to talk about art integrated projects and art integrated learning, which CBSE is recently introduced. The notification has come somewhere in the month of 14th of May 2020, and before that also 8th March they have notified it. These notifications were of course were there, but due to COVID and due to the other reasons, we are just overlooked it, or rather we are just missed it, okay, because the school's activities were very much reduced. But now it is a time that we have to see it, okay. So now what are the things? Like, CBSE has introduced art education as a mandatory for all the classes, and its activities must be uploaded to Kalasetu website, Kalasetu or Art Integrated and Art Integrated Learning website. So this is a website in which every child's information has to be uploaded, which child or what class has conducted what type of activities and all. It includes two activities. One is art integrated project and second is art integrated learning. Art integrated project is only for students of class 1 to 10, whereas art integrated learning is there for all the students right from the class 1 to class 12th. Okay, art integrated project is a project in which the children will be making a project using any kind of art. Now CBSE is also emphasized another thing here, that is Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat topic. And Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat means the India is a vast country and which have got various kind of art spread throughout the world, throughout the country. Now these arts can be in the form of drawing, in the form of painting, in the form of dances, in the form of folklore, in the form of various type of sculptures and historic monuments are there, and many other type of things are there. Modern arts are there, buildings are there, dams are there, agriculture itself is an art, dairy farming itself is art. So there are variety of arts spread throughout the country. Now this particular branch of the art integrated project and art integrated learning is emphasizing the students to go and learn about them, at least one topic. And also the CBSE has given every state is that CBSE is linked every state with some other state. So we in Rajasthan, we have given Assam as a linked state. So in the art integrated project, at least one project every child has to make on one of the art related to Assam. Okay, now further I'll elaborate here, that is what type of project they have to make and how many projects they have to make and all. Art integrated learning is actually these projects what we are making, out of that what extract we get, that is what type of art education we have got, or how we can use that into the scientific or any other subjects understanding. So that is a different topic, and these two topics we have to study. First we'll study about the art integrated project. Art integrated project is only for the students of class 1 to 10. Class 11th and 12th need not to make any project, okay, but they have their own project in the, they got their project in languages in the form of ASL, in if it is the commerce subject, they got some projects on them. If they got science subject, they got project in that also. If mathematics is there, they got project in that also. And if they got physical education, computer science or any other science, so every science has got, every subject has got some project. So that project will be including the art integrated learning, okay. So that we'll discuss little later. First we are talking about the art integrated project. So your project can be based on either visual arts or performance art. Now when we talk about the visual arts can be two dimensional, which includes drawing, painting, sketching, stitching, and beside that model making by mud and wax and plaster and flourish, these are actually three dimensional, okay. So two dimensional include drawing, painting, sketching and stitching, and that can also be there. And three dimensional, which you can get in the form of model, So they can be clay model, they can be thermocol model, they can be plastic model, they can be glass, or they can be building material and all, whatever type of things, whatever type of things you can make use, and you can see it or get it a three dimensional vision, then it is three dimensional visual arts. And performance arts include all kind of activities like singing, dancing, or elocution, or extempore, or debate, or dialogue, or whatever type of thing, poetry, skit, etc. Okay, so these are performance arts are mainly related to languages, and beside this, the civics, in which we have to take some of the topics from the debates like Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha and other type of things, and it can even be used in other sciences also, other topic, other subjects also. Like in science, you can ask the child to speak about on some scientist, or to explain certain laws, etc. So it is up to children and up to teacher how they want to make use of it. So you got two different ways by which you can have the art integrated project. It can be in the form of visual arts, or it can be in the form of performance art. But whatever art you are making, you have to make a small project on that in the form of file. Okay, the next is the art integrated project for class 1 to 10. What they have to do, students of class 1 to 10 have to make art integrated project on topic of their pair state. Now, pair state, I said there is a list which is given on the website. Over there, on this PDF, all the information regarding this project and art integrated learning is given. You have to go to page number 5, where the state and their pair state is given. So your state, suppose my state is Rajasthan, so Rajasthan is paired with Assam. Similarly, there are a number of other states. All the states are there, and the states are paired with some other states. So the student of Rajasthan has to learn about the various type of arts, various type of culture, various type of other activities which are going on in Assam. So that is what this particular topic is meant for. Now, student of class 1 to 8, all the students of class 1 to 8 have to make only one project. Okay? Have to make a single project which cover all 5 subjects. Now, we are talking about the 5 subjects, not of computer science. We are not talking about the drawing. We are not talking about the GK. We are not talking about the value education. We are not talking about environment studies. We are talking about only 5 subjects. These 5 subjects are Hindi, English, SST, Mathematics, Science. Okay, so these are the 5 subjects on which they have to make only one project which is covering all 5 subjects. Okay, and class 9th and 10th have to make one project each in Hindi, English, SST, General Science and Mathematics. But remember, only any one project should be based on the paired state, not all 5. Any one project should be based on the paired state. So they can choose either language, they can choose either science or SST or on this thing. I'll give you some idea that what type of projects we can make. Next is at least one art integrated project for class 1 to 8. Now only one project they have to make. Only one project they have to make, that is from the for the student of class 1 to 8. But they have got freedom that they want to make more subjects project, they can make. Okay, now one project what they got, that should include all the 5 subjects. Now let us say under the topic of Ek Bharat Shrest Bharat, the paired state whatever we are making, we are emphasizing onto this topic, that is Ek Bharat Shrest Bharat. Now so you can choose a project on any of these topic. Your topic can be, that is the topic of project can be either culture or painting or music or dance or drama or sculpture, resources, economy, history, monuments, dams, agriculture, and there are number of other things, but you have to use any of those things. Suppose you are you are using any historical monument. So historical monument now, when you are selected, you can integrate it with all sciences, all subjects. How it is done, that I'll explain in the next slide. Classes 1 to 8 have to make only one project, which must cover all 5 subjects. So now it is a special duty for the teachers. So the teachers of all the subjects can sit together and discuss to give a topic which is related to all the subjects. Anyway, you give any topic that can be related to all 5 subjects, but the teacher should emphasize depending on the child's caliber. Now you cannot ask the class 1 child to make a project in such a way that which will discuss or which will cover all 5 subjects. So you will have to make them understand that what type of project you can make, what topic you can choose, right? So I said the student of class 1 to 8 has to make only one project which should cover all the 5 subjects. Next, art integrated project for class 9th and 10th. When we come about the 9th and 10th, then they have to make 5 projects, that is one in each subject. So for classes 9th and 10th, one has to make one project each on Hindi, English, SST, Maths and General Science. Remember, one thing is there, any one project should be based on to the related state. You need not to make all 5 projects related to the paired state. Okay, any one. So it can be in Hindi, or it can be in English, or it can be in General Science, or it can be in SST, or it can be in Mathematics. Okay, any one project you can make on the paired state, and the other projects you can have normal project based on to the other topics. So the topic of any one project can be from arts or craft or agriculture or mineral resources or rivers, mining, dams, dresses, rivers, etc. Many other topics are there, you can choose topic. Your project can be from 5 to 20 pages in length depending on your class and the topic what you are choosing. Now suppose you are giving audio files, or you are giving a performance. So one who is giving performance, why should he make 20 pages? Then he can write everything within 3 or 5 or 6 pages. But if it is his project is only the written information, then he has to include pictures, he has to use some other things to make his project appealing, and it should be somewhere about 20 pages for class and 9th and 10th, not for the other classes. I'm talking only of 9th and 10th. So for the students of 9th and 10th, it can be of up to 20 pages, and minimum 5 pages only for those who are having their project in the performance side. Okay, now art integrated learning, this is entirely new topic. Now remember, this information took very long for me to understand even what is meant by the art education, art integrated learning and art integrated project. So that it's a very hodgepodge thing, so I am making it very clear. Now see, art integrated learning is actually a learning which you have learned through those arts. Suppose it is you are chosen drawing, so where you can use these drawing. Suppose you are learned painting, your project was to learn painting, that is there was some wall painting or there was some other type of painting, or suppose Assamese particular type of saris are there on which they are having certain type of painting, or some type of sculptures are there, then you have to know that what type of designs they use. So those things where you can use. So first of all, from the project you have to learn those art integrated learning, that is, so what type of things are there, and then where you can use it, how you used it in science, how you used in maths, how you used it in other sciences. I'll just explain in the next thing. So see, the second aspect of art integrated project is art integrated learning, which emphasizes what you have learned and how this can be used in the study of other subjects. You have to integrate it with the other subjects. Now each topic can be integrated. Suppose I learned mathematics, suppose there was a sculpture, and I learned how to make areas, how to calculate areas. So these, the topic of area, I can use in all other subjects also. So that is how we have to use it. So that is called art integrated learning. Okay. When you make an art integrated project, you must specify art integrated learning, that is using that product, what art integrated learning you had. Okay. On separate sheet, as to show what you have learned, and how this can be used in the study of other subjects. Okay. What you have learned and how this can be used in study of other subject or explanation of other subjects. Okay. Next is art integrated learning for classes 1 to 12. You can make a group of 5 to 6 students. Now when they are making project, it is not necessary that every child has to individually go and learn. Of course, now you need not to, you know, you have very this thing, you got a lot of resources, like you can go to the internet, or you can get some magazines from the market and you can make your project. You need not to go there. You will get all the pictures, you will all the photography, all the information on the internet only you get. So what you have to do is, instead of sitting individually, what you can do is you can make a group of 5 to 6 students. Now CBSE has again specified that how to make group, that is a group should consist of some intelligent students, some mediocre students, some weak students, some boys, some girls. So it should not be that all the intelligent boys will go and make one group. It is not that all the poor boys, all the weaker boys will make one group, or all economically sound children will make one group and their project can be very beautiful, and those who are economically weak, they will make. No, the class teacher can decide that which 5 students can be there in a group, or they can let them choose their own, but see that there is no clear-cut distinction that all the intelligent students have made one group and all the weaker students have made one group, or all the boys are in together. All that can be done, no problem. Boys can be stay together, girls can stay together, no problem. We can also emphasize when the cities are big enough, then they should be staying somewhere nearby. Okay, so that they can meet together, they can make project, or they can, of course, now that is not a very big issue because everything is on the mobile and telephone nowadays. So the meeting, and that is not very important thing, because now you got Google Meet, you got Zoom meeting, you got WhatsApp calling, where you can anywhere, you can even sitting in the abroad in any other city can also make projects. So that distance is not a very big issue. Okay, now another thing, how a whole class, that is the 5 or 6 students will be there in a team, how a whole class can either make one single topic, a project on one single topic, or they can choose different topic. That is again very important thing. Now if a class teacher decide ki these 5 students will make project on agriculture, these 5 will make on the monuments, these 5 will make on their dance, and these 5 will make on their drawing, and these 5 will, so of course you get a variety, but we have to take care, we have to think that the project should be of more or less of same costing and same type of info. It should not be that somebody has to struggle a lot and the others will, for others it can be easy and all. So these teachers will have it is better that the teacher come in between and they decide the topic and they give, otherwise let the freedom can be in the senior classes, you can give the freedom to the student itself. But now another thing, but the report must be written individually. Learning can be done together, that is very important, because here there will be exchange of ideas, there will be one child may see something else, the other child may something else, so there will be more information can be gathered. So making group is better for studies, but report should be made individually. Okay. Now your project in case of languages can be in the performance arts, like dialogue or debate or elocution or extempo, okay, in the form of dance or any other form. So these can even go into ASL. Now one more thing, that is whatever projects we are making, they will be marked for subject enrichment. So suppose you are making a project in SST, so your subject as enrichment project will be this project itself. Okay, this art integrated project will be used in their subject enrichment also, and so the marks will be given there. Okay, art integrated project and art integrated learning as such are not containing any extra marks or any marking subject, but this is a criteria which every student has to go through. That is a very important thing. Okay, now the next thing is that is art. Now here some of the ideas are given, like art integrated project and learning. For example, if you make project on monuments, any monument, okay, then you can integrate it with all other subjects. How? Languages are there, all the documentation, folklore. If suppose something is there, naturally it should have been described in so many folklores, or some descriptions must be there. Why that particular thing has been made, those all descriptions you can write. History, who made it, why made it, how it made it, and all other type of all information, that is what type of things is used and who made, and whether it has been attacked other times or not, and also you got a lot of history, so that can be there. Geography, if you are making now SST, history and geography are the part of SST only. So in geography, if you are seeing, you have to see the location, you have to see the topography, you have to see latitude and longitude, that can also be given, you know, and other information can be used, and also you can give that what type of material is used and all. Okay, when you talk about the mathematics, it shows the measurements and angles, and the dome are there, then the domes can be considered, or if it is rectangular or square or whatever type of things are there, there is lot of geometry involved, there is lot of mathematics involved. Okay, so size can be there, and if sizes are there, then the intercompatibility changeability can be used, or etc. And when we talk about the science, now nothing is there in which the science is not involved. Leave the folklore and poetry, other things there will be definitely some science. Even in that also you can say science, that is the sound pitches and etc. you can use. But suppose there is a monument is there, now since we are taking an example of a monument, so there will be lot of science. Now what science are there, that is the what type of building materials are used, what type of cementing substance were used, whether they use rods etc. or the center of gravity, or what you call the thickness of the walls etc. and then the other things you can see, that that is if the plantation is there, that what type of plantations are there and all etc. and there are a lot of things. So science can also, you have to integrate it, think, sit together in a group and think that what science is involved in this. There will be definitely some physics, there will be definitely in some chemistry, there will definitely be some bio. Take another example here, art integrated project for class 1 to 10. If you make a project on the agriculture, say for example Assam, what type of agriculture is there, suppose pediculture is there, or some other type of culture, slash and boom is there, or some other type of there, then what you can, you have to describe it. It will be somewhere in their poetry, in their folklore, or it can be in their songs and etc. will be there. History, that is when they have started this agriculture, how they have come approach about this thing, what type of seeds they are using and all, hiding varieties they started using or not using and all those things type of things. Then geography, what kind of soil is there, seasons are there, weathers are there, and then rivers, what type of rivers are there, storage facility. Science, if you are using, then what type of insecticide, pesticide, irrigation, storage facilities, insecticides are there, then what type of chemicals are used in there, pesticides and all. Okay, and what are side effects and all those things. And mathematics are there, then the cultivable areas in the various unit and their productivity, how much production was there, and their relationship and all those things. So you have to just think, and the project, the integration will be there definitely. Okay, for class 11th and 12th, no need to make any project. because art integrated के नाम पे, दैट इज इन द नेम ऑफ आर्ट इंटीग्रेटेड प्रोजेक्ट, दे नीड नॉट टू मेक एनी प्रोजेक्ट बिकॉज दे आर मेकिंग प्रोजेक्ट इन ऑल देयर सब्जेक्ट्स. दे आर मेकिंग प्रोजेक्ट इन कंप्यूटर साइंस, दे आर मेकिंग इन ऑल द साइंस, फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री बायो, दे आर मेकिंग इन मैथमेटिक्स, दे आर मेकिंग इन फिजिकल एजुकेशन, दे आर मेकिंग इन कॉमर्स सब्जेक्ट्स एंड ऑल, इकोनॉमिक्स में भी, इन बिजनेस में भी, इन ऑल. सो दे आर मेकिंग प्रोजेक्ट सेपरेटली, सो दे नीड नॉट टू मेक एनी प्रोजेक्ट ऑन द आर्ट इंटीग्रेटेड प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, बट दे हैव टू यूज आर्ट इंटीग्रेटेड लर्निंग टू मेक देयर प्रोजेक्ट मोर यूजफुल. सो दे विल मेक अनदर शॉर्ट फाइल इन विच दे विल स्पेसिफाई, दैट इज इन माई फिजिक्स प्रोजेक्ट आई यूज दीज दीज थिंग्स एज आर्ट इंटीग्रेटेड, लाइक लाइन्स, if he has drawn the diagrams and all, so then those things will be there. In the chemistry is there, so then what type of chemicals are there and all, bio is there, then what type, so all those things he has to make as a project, separate project, very small, maybe of one page on each project, and that he has to submit separately to the related teacher. Okay, and when everything is done, then these subjects marks will be given, these projects marks will be given in the subject enrichment. So they see, once the art integrated project and art integrated learning, that is subject enrichment work, is collected, the information has to be uploaded into the CBSE Kala Setu or art integrated website. Okay, so that is a detailed work. So all the teachers now have to decide then what type of project they have to give, when they have to give, when they have to collect, so that the informations can be kept ready as and when CBSE ask. Now you can upload, site is already open from the December, mid-December, the site is already open, so the teachers, marks can be uploaded, not marks, like informations can be uploaded, that there will be a separate video that how the information has to be uploaded, because information itself has to be uploaded in 5 steps. Okay, so once step one, only the names of the teachers and their phone numbers will be kept. That is all the teachers who are included in the art education. They may be drawing teacher, they may be performance art, like dance teachers, they may be modeling teachers, or they may be science teacher, or they may be maths teacher. All those teachers who are teaching art in one form or other, their names and their telephone number will be collected in first information. Then second, the detailing will be there, that is if the project work is given, that how many periods are in allotted for art integration for each classes, and according to CBSE site, CBSE 2 periods every week. Okay, so that will be there, that can be fed there, that in the time period, which days and which period is allotted for that thing, and then the project, when is given and when it is collected, that is the duration of the project work, that will be, these information will be collected in second thing. Third stage is there, in which the children, what projects, what topics are given, and accordingly there is a annexure given, on which all the informations are given, that is each type of art activity has got a certain number, that number you have to feed there. Okay, and other informations are to be filled. So this is how the fourth and fifth pages will also be filled, and everything is filled, then when we'll upload it, then a certain number comes, those numbers we have to keep it ready, then only the admit card of class 10th and 12th will be downloaded, otherwise there is no chance that the admit card will be downloaded, and the children will be finding it difficult on the last moment to take exams and all. So that's all, children. That's all, and teachers. And if you still got any problem, you can contact me. Thank you. And if you like it, please like and share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.